Over the course of the last year, a new ingredient has entered the skincare market, claiming to boost superhuman benefits in terms of fighting skin discoloration. Tranexamic acid. Time to take a closer look. Hi, I'm Dr. Anne. I'm a medical doctor with a passion for skincare that works. On this channel, we explore the science behind skin and do quick reviews so you learn to pick exactly those products that work for your individual skin concern. So if this is something you're interested in, please consider subscribing and ring the notification bell. In today's video, I want to talk about what is tranexamic acid, what does tranexamic acid do for the skin, does tranexamic acid have any side effects, and does tranexamic acid work for sure? First things first, what is tranexamic acid? Tranexamic acid, or trans-4-aminomethylcyclohexanecarboxylic acid, say that three times fast. Tranexamic acid is a plasmine inhibitor, which was used as hemostatic agent to treat abnormal fibrinolysis in excessive bleeding. It's a synthetic derivative of the amino acid lysine and was originally used more in intensive care settings or in the labor ward for conditions with increased fibrinolysis, which in plain English means that the blood did not clot as it should be, so the bleeding wouldn't stop. Outside from emergency treatment, it was mainly used orally to treat hypermenorrhea or abnormal menstrual bleeding, for example. It also made its first skincare appearance as a treatment for prurigo, which is excessive itching, in as early as 1979. The overall skin brightening effect was kind of an accidental find, because people realized after they've been taking it orally to treat their hypermenorrhea for several years, their skin looked much more even, was less prone to hyperpigmentation than in the ones that did not take the medication. So what does tranexamic acid do for the skin? Well, there have been several studies that have shown that tranexamic acid helps improve melasma and seems to be beneficial for other forms of hyperpigmentation as well. Just a quick recap, melasma is a bifacial symmetrical hyperpigmentation, often here or around the mouth, while hyperpigmentation is not symmetrical, it's just these dark spots that you get, like age spots or liver spots. Both are, however, triggered by the same mechanism, which is an irregular deposit of melanin in melasma, triggered by hormonal imbalances, in other cases triggered by inflammation and sun exposure. Tranexamic acid now works by inhibiting the plasminogen plasmin pathway, which also interferes with melanin production in the skin, leading to overall brighter skin and the reduction in melasma. Different from hyperpigmentation and melasma is post-inflammatory erythema, which is not a brown spot but a red spot, a red mark that is left over most often after a pimple. We do not have enough data to be sure that tranexamic acid works on this as well, but as plasmin plays an important role in angiogenesis, which is the building of new blood vessels which leads to this persistent redness, it could help with that too. Now, does tranexamic acid have any side effects? Well, you can be allergic to everything, but in general, tranexamic acid has little reported side effects. What you might expect is dry skin, scaling of the skin, flaky skin if you use a high concentration, and in a few number of cases, there was erythema, like overall redness reported. All of these side effects are much less common as they are with hydroquinone or retinoids, for example. Tranexamic acid is also safe to be mixed with other acids or vitamin C if your skin can tolerate it. I personally recommend you keep your actives separate as much as possible, but if your skin is fine with it, you could mix tranexamic acid with other things that fight hyperpigmentation in the same setting. So does tranexamic acid work in skincare for sure? Sadly, we can't say that just yet. While we do have a lot of data on tranexamic acid and its skin lightening properties, we do not have a lot of data on topically applied tranexamic acid. The method of application done in the studies so far has a wide range, ranging from intravenous application over oral application up to topical application or even injections. And if you just look at the topical applications, you had liposomal creams, emulsions, gels, all different kinds of forms of application and different concentrations. This diversity means that we know for sure that tranexamic acid works, but we have the most data for oral application, and we can't just transfer oral application to topical application. although there have been a few smaller but promising studies over the last few years. Another thing that's unclear is which form of application is actually best, because water-based tranexamic acid might have a hard time to penetrate through the lipid barrier of the skin. The concentrations in the studies ranged from 0.5% up to 5%, and we can't say for sure which one is the most effective concentration. I can tell you though that over the counter you usually get 2% max. But again, that does not mean it does not work. Absence of proof is not proof of absence. We just need some more data. And if you now tell me I'm confused, just tell me what to do. Well, so far the safest way to make sure it is effective would be to take oral tranexamic acid. But oral tranexamic acid is not without side effects. It is a very potent drug that I have used many times through my hospital career to stop people from bleeding to death. But if you, as someone that is healthy and has no underlying bleeding conditions, takes it, it might mess with your blood clotting time. I, for one, would never be allowed to take it because I already had a deep vein thrombosis. And taking it as an oral medication would increase my risk for stroke, for thrombosis, myocardial or cerebral infarction, or pulmonary embolism. Not something I personally would risk for treating hyperpigmentation. So my advice would be, even though the data is limited, stick to topical application. Look for a product that gives you the maximum concentration that you can get over the counter, which is 2%. I'm going to do a few follow-up reviews with tranexamic acid containing products so you can see what's on the market right now. But don't put all your hopes in this one ingredient. Use it as part of a balanced routine. Use it with retinoids, with acids, with vitamin C, with arbutin, and of course with a broad spectrum SPF and a sun avoidance strategy, and don't expect miracles overnight. Hyperpigmentation is really stubborn to treat. Yes, some studies showed that it had an effect as soon as 6 to 8 weeks, but usually seeing an effect, an improvement in hyperpigmentation will take up to 6 months. So bottom line, yes, tranexamic acid might work. No, it's not the end all be all in skincare ingredients. I would not rely solely on it if I had hyperpigmentation to treat. I would use it as part of a balanced skincare routine that combines different ingredients tackling hyperpigmentation. And above all, prevention is the best cure. Wear your SPF, wear a hat when you go outside, reapply your sunscreen, and you should see improvements in the next 6 months. Please tell me in the comments below if you have tried tranexamic acid products. I'm going to link to more videos on the screen that I think you might enjoy. And I'm going to see you all very soon with another one. Bye.